rebuild our home children.
Amen.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
It's a wonderful day. Every day is wonderful to our God. Every day that you wake up in the morning, you must give glory to God. Because he said it's not by might, it is not by your power. It is by his spirit that he kept you alive. It is not even by righteousness. It is his own righteousness that he kept you alive. So in every situation that you are, as long as you have life, you must always give praises. Because in your praises, you will be victorious.
Amen.
And you should also know that in your storm, in the time of difficulties, and in the time of sorrow, in the time of despair, in the time of stress, when everybody will neglect you, when you will see no one beside you, God is always there.
Yes.
To comfort you.
Yes.
To lift you up. To give you blessings. And to enrich your life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So today we give glory to God for all that he has done in your life and in my life also.
Thank you, Lord.
Today is special. Every day is special. But today, two people special to us are celebrating their birthday. And this could have been done otherwise, but they chose to come before the presence of the Lord. And I thank the Lord for their life.
Thank
I thank the Lord for their children.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank the Lord for their grandchildren.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank the Lord for what he has done for them.
Thank
you, Lord. For the church as a whole, for the family of Abdul. I thank the Lord. I thank the Lord for the family of Malik for what he has done. And I thank God for the life of everyone that are seated here today. I pray that the glory of God will continue to shine in your heart.
Amen.
We are here, Mary. I know you know Mary. Mary, can you please stand up for recognition? Yeah, that's my daughter.
You are welcome in the name of the Lord.
Mary.
You are welcome in the name of the Lord. I can see all about you.
She's close in Atlanta, and there's
you are welcome in the name of the Lord.
You are welcome in the name of the Lord.
But I know that he's here with us in spirit. Please be seated. His name is Jerry. Lord, wherever that it is, I know that the spirit is here with me. And when you see Mama, God smiles so much. He has the biggest smile in the whole world. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everything. She smiles at everything. It's a woman that has no strength. That's the joy that makes her to smile all the time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I'm glad to have my daughters here. My daughter Mary is in RN. I'm going to take all the money that belongs to me today. She owed me so much. Hallelujah. She knows that. Hallelujah. I told her the last time that I went to her, I said, do you really know me? said, I know you, sir. I said, no, ask your mother. Your mother will tell you who I am because I'm very important to you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't look like it, but I am a very important person to the apostles. May God continue to bless the apostles in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Of course, for this birthday celebrate, I thank the Lord for your life. I thank the Lord for the strength that the Lord has given you. Even in the time of weakness, I thank the Lord for you. Because I say that this man, I've known him for over 30 years. Hallelujah. And I've known him to be most dedicated, hardworking person that I have ever seen. You might not believe it, but I stand here in the presence of the Lord. Because I remember when I was the assistant shepherd and when I was the chairman at New York Parish, he was like the maintenance officer. And everything that has to do with maintenance, fixing the roof, fixing the floor, the carpet, he was in charge. He has the key to the church. And he comes to church and I really thank from then, 30 years even up till now, you can tell that he's still working so hard. Even now, he has more responsibility, not only in our church, but also in the state, because these are one of those that have said that this church cannot remain the same. It cannot remain stagnant.
Amen.
The Celestial Church of God is a glorious church that was descended from heaven and above. And that we have to do things right, we have to do it with fruitfulness, and we have to walk righteously with God. And hallelujah, these people have been walking tirelessly, and I tell you that even the wife, Mama Abdul, will tell you that she doesn't see him at home. Hallelujah, because if he's not in one meeting, it will be another meeting. Hallelujah, and I thank the Lord for you, because I know that you are not doing it, nobody has even given you a reward for anything. Since I've known him for 30 years, I've never even seen anybody that says thank you to him for all that he does. Hallelujah.
He is a great thing to serve the Lord. He is a great thing to serve the Lord. He is a great thing to serve the Lord. Walking in the light of God.
Hallelujah.
Something that's special about you is that you are very dedicated and a very dependent person. In the vineyard. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I don't want distraction. You know me. I get distracted so easily. I just want the Spirit of the Lord to flow. We all flow with it so that we can all benefit. Hallelujah. Because too many times people, when they die, then people start to speak good things about them when they cannot appreciate it. And believe me, either you want to believe me or not, I stand here to give a testimony about a man that I know for 30 years. He's not a perfect man. I'm not talking about perfection, and I'm not talking about a righteous man that has no sin. I am talking about what I see in a man for 30 years of dedicated service to the work of God in celestial form. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I want to let you know that today that you are special. You are not only special to this church. Hallelujah. You are special in the eyes of the Lord.
Amen.
And I pray that the Lord will continue to favor you.
Amen.
He will continue to bless you with
Amen.
Your children. Your children, they will become a great man and a great woman of God.
Amen. Amen.
God, you will worship Lord unto the end.
Amen.
You will never, darkness will not prevail over you.
Amen.
Power of darkness can never prevail over your children.
Amen.
And your household.
Amen.
May you be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Power of greatness, God will endow you with.
Amen.
Power of inspiration. Power of uniqueness, God will endow you with.
Amen.
And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
And I want to talk briefly about money after also. Because inside a successful
Hallelujah.
Man. Hallelujah.
Psalm 92.
Psalm 92.
It says, the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree.
Yes.
It shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon.
Mm-hmm.
Those who have planted the house of the Lord shall flourish in the house of our God.
Amen.
Mr. Abdul, you shall bear fruit in old age.
Amen.
And you shall be fresh and refreshed.
Amen.
To declare that the Lord is upright.
Amen.
He is your rock and there is no unrighteousness.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
All glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
About her, I've known her as much as I've known my brother here. And one thing that I know about her is if there's say for 30 years that I've known her, I've never heard that somebody said she said something. I've never had no negativity about her. I've never had nothing about this woman for 30 years. Hallelujah. And believe me, we worship in a place that Prince Dino by then was all over the place. Hallelujah. But there's something about this woman that I bet in the foreground that I've never had anything wrong.